Welcome to class 7 of Indian Financial System. In the last class, we have already dealt with instruments of money market. And in this class, we are going to discuss about participants in money market. So who all are the participants? Who all are the major players in the money market? So theoretically, anyone can be the participant in the market. Yet, market practices and regulatory pronouncements have placed certain restrictions on participants for each of sub-markets in the money market. So, for example, call money market is open to only banks, financial institutions, insurance companies, and mutual funds can only lend in the market. So, it would therefore be useful to know the participants in each of sub-markets of money market. So, there are some lists and profiles of participants which participate both in money market as well as in debt portion of capital market, while resident entities are participants in these markets. So this section covers a larger and major participants or players. So the first is your central government. So as it is given in the slide, the central government is an issuer of Indian securities. So issuer of government of India securities. So what we call it as G6. Okay. And treasury bills. Short form is like T-bills. So these instruments are issued to finance the government as well as for managing the government's cash flow. So government securities are dated securities, are those which have specific maturity and coupon payment dates embedded into the terms of issues, debt obligations of the central government. So these bonds are issued by RBI. This is on behalf of government, so as to finance the later budget requirements, deficits and public sectors development programs. So these bonds are issued throughout the financial year. The calendar of issuance of this government securities is decided at the beginning of half of the every financial year. So T-bills are the short-term debts, obligations of central government. So these are discounted instruments. So these may form part of a budgetary borrowing or be issued for managing the government's cash flow. So T-bills allow the government to manage its cash flow position since revenue collections are bounced whereas revenue expenditures are depressed. Next is state government. So the state government issues the security termed as state development loans, so which are medium to long term maturity bonds floated to enable state governments to fund their budget deficits. The next major player or participants in money market is public sector. So public sector undertakings, they issue bonds which are medium to long term coupon bearing debt securities. So public sector undertaking bonds can be of two types, taxable and tax free bonds. So these bonds are issued to finance the working capital requirements and long term projects of public sector undertakings. Public sector undertakings can also issue commercial paper to finance their working capital requirement. So like any other business organization, public sector undertakings generate large cash surpluses. Such public sector undertakings are active investors in instruments like fixed deposits, certificates of deposits, and treasury bills. Some of the public sector undertakings with long-term cash surpluses are also active investors in government securities and bonds. The next participants, scheduled commercial banks. So banks issue certificate of deposits which are unsecured and they are the negotiable instruments. These are usually issued at the discount to the face value. So they are issued in a period when a bank's deposit volumes are low and banks perceive that they can get the funds at the lowest or the low interest rate. Their period of issue ranges from 7 to 1 year. So scheduled commercial banks also participate in the overnight, so that is called as call and term markets. They can participate both as a lender as well as a borrower in the call money market and term markets. So these banks use these funds in their day-to-day and short-term liquidity management. Call money is an important tool to manage the cash reserve ratio commitments. The next is private sector companies. Private sector companies issue commercial papers and corporate debentures. Commercial papers are short-term, negotiable, discounted debt instruments. So they are issued in the form of unsecured promissory notes. They are used when corporations want to raise their short-term capital directly from the market instead of borrowing from banks. So corporate debentures are coupon-bearing medium to long-term instruments which are issued by the corporation when they want to assess a loan to finance projects and working capital requirements. Corporate debentures can be issued as fully or partially or partly convertible into shares of the issuing corporation. So bonds which do not have convertibility clause are known as non-convertible bonds. So these bonds can be issued with a fixed or floating interest rate. So depending on the stipulated availability of security, these bonds could be classified as a secured and or unsecured public private sector companies with cash surpluses are active investors in the investment. So like your fixed deposits, certificates of deposits, treasury bills. Some of these companies with active treasuries are also active participants in your government securities and others. The next is provident fund. Provident funds have short-term and long-term surplus fund. They invest their fund in a debt instruments according to their internal guideline as to how much they can invest in the instrument category. Okay, so the instrument, some of the instruments that provident fund provident funds can invest in are like your government securities, state development loans, bonds guaranteed by the central and state governments. So bonds or obligations of public sector, so private sector public sector undertakings. Okay, and the financial institutions. So bonds issued by the private sector's companies carrying an acceptable level of rating by at least two rating agencies. The next is general insurance company. General insurance companies have to maintain certain funds which have to be invested in the approved investments. So they participate in the government securities, bonds and short-term money markets as a lender. So it is seen that generally they do not assess fund from these markets. So the next is your life insurance companies. So LICs invest their funds in the government securities, bonds or short-term money markets. So they have certain predetermined thresholds as to how much they can invest in each category of investment. Next is mutual funds. Mutual funds invest their funds in money market and debt instrument. The proportion of the fund which they can invest in any one instrument vary or differ according to the approved investment pattern declared in each scheme. The next we see is non-banking financial companies, NBFCs. So NBFCs invest their fund in debt instruments to fulfill certain regulatory mandates or mandatories as well as to park their surplus funds. So NBFCs are required to invest 15% of their net worth in the bond which fulfill the statutory liquidity ratio requirements. Then the next is your primary dealers. The organizations of primary dealers was convened and permitted by the Reserve Bank of India in 1995. So these are institutional entities registered with RBI. So role of your primary dealers. So like they provide underwriting services. They commit participation as the principals in Government of India issues through bidding and auctions. So to offer the firms buy and sell bid ask quotes for the T-bills and dated securities and to improve secondary market trading system. So which would contribute to price discovery. Then they are going to strengthen the infrastructure in the government securities market in order to make it vibrant, liquid and broad base. So to make the primary dealers an effective conduit for conducting a open market operation. So thank you.